What's going on, guys? My name is Sankas, and in this video I want to go through this patch which I have here. It's kind of inspired by some Virtual Riot stuff, and it's kind of interesting sounding. It sounds like this. And yeah, let's go ahead and cover this. I'm going to start with the sub, which is the easiest part here. Just a sine wave sent directly out, and two octaves down, and this LFO1, which is the main modulator, just sent to the level, and just kind of cleaning it up and giving the sub some wobble. And I'm using the Reese Mess 2 wavetable by Seamless, which you can find under Spectral right over here. And what I did is I went to the oscillator A table edit, as I typically like to do, and I applied the Squarify formula preset here. So as you can see, the formula presets window here, just click that, go to multis, select proc Squarify, and we get a different kind of overtone from it. So I inserted the LFO1, which is triggered and 1 over 4 by default, onto the wavetable position as well as the level. Again, the level to kind of clean up the sound and give this sound some more movement, some more defined movement. And then the wavetable position is what gives it a lot of that screechiness. But also spread it out 16 voices and brought the detune down quite a bit, so it spread out a bit. But a lot of the squelchiness comes from what's happening with the FMing here. So you can see I have FM from B selected. And pretty much it's set around a little less than halfway. And the FM source is just a sawtooth wave. So as you can see, it's just a sawtooth. And here's what it sounds like without the mirror function. Sounds quite different, not vastly different, but quite different, not as squelchy. So what I did here is I turned the level down, and again, FM from B, so this is our FM source, kept the octave and everything where it is, very default. All I did was change this to mirror, and that warps the sawtooth wave in a way that it gives it some squelchy characteristics when modulated by this LFO1. Let's go ahead and take that off. So it kind of gives a little bit more movement, some interesting textures, and a bit of squelchiness I found. Sounds a little less static, so I thought this was a very cool thing to do. This is how I got started making this whole patch, actually, was just finding out that this mirror function, some interesting stuff to this main wavetable. So I went ahead and I filtered it with the high pass peak filter 12 filter, one of my go-tos for creating kind of vowel-y basses or trying to tighten up a sound a bit more and make it sound a bit more talky. So you can see it has this high pass cutoff knob here, which I've modulated with LFO1. Also has this frequency knob here, which you get from boosting the resonance. And I'm modulating that in the opposite direction and just kind of sweeping towards the high pass filter. So in my opinion, it kind of defines the sound a bit more, so I like that to do this kind of stuff with these kinds of sounds. And I kind of emphasize what's going on here with the wavetable position squelchiness and then the extra squelchiness coming from this mirror thing, and just kind of again emphasize that. Some basic hyperdimension expansion here. Actually, the dimension expansion is not even engaged, it's off, so just a bit of hyper to kind of widen out the sound a bit. And then distortion, very default settings here, except for the drive is just cranked up a bit to around 75%. And without this, without the distortion, the hyperdimension expansion sounds like this. So it just kind of thickens it out a little bit. Not as audible, but it's there. And it gives a little bit of a different texture. Again, not much, but all these things kind of come together subtly. So in the EQ, I've set up kind of almost the same filter as in the filter over here. Instead of the high pass peak filter, I've made a high pass notch filter. So I've switched this to high pass and I'm modulating the frequency with the LFO1. And I've set this to a peak and just took it down to create a notch. And I'm modulating the frequency once again in the opposite direction and having it intersect around the mids to low mids section. And that gives it more of a kind of screechy sound and maybe even more, not higher pitch, but a higher kind of timbre, if that's the appropriate word to use for that. And also the EQ by default comes after the compressor, so I just brought it up before all the other stuff that I was doing here, right after the distortion. And I've got this reverb filter here as well, which I've brought before the distortion, because it defaults to being after distortion, compression, excuse me. So brought it up after the EQ and before compression. And again, I selected reverb filter under multis. And I'm modulating that as well with LFO1 in bipolar mode, so it's going into positive and negative values. And I'm just mixing that in again with around 70%. And it just gives it some weird, interesting texture since it's a really strange kind of filter. So what I would probably do with this is just bring a macro on the mix and be able to go between reverb filter and no reverb filter on the fly, since it does sound kind of cool without it. But I do like the overtones and the kind of texture it gets from it, so it's nice to have as an option. So last but not least, in the effects section, we've got this compressor, which is set to multi-band mode. I've boosted the gain quite a bit. Ratio attack and release are at the default settings, but I took the threshold up a bit, and then I'm modulating it with the LFO1, which is giving it a bit more dynamics, and it's kind of an interesting thing to modulate since you're modulating what decides where the compression starts to kick in. So really interesting, weird stuff here. Makes a fat, but not as fat and squashed as it would be if this threshold was just not modulated and set at this value. So again, a bit more dynamics. Here's where the interesting thing comes in. Since we've got this main LFO as our main modulator, you can see it's still changing speeds. So that is being changed by LFO2. These steps here determine the LFO rate of LFO1. So in the matrix, I just went ahead and chose LFO. Let's see, oh, where is it? Now I gotta find it. There it is, all the way up here. So in the matrix over here, I just chose LFO2 for the mod source. So LFO2 is the modulation source. It's modulating something. So I cranked up the amount a bit, the mod matrix depth to, I guess, around 41. I just kind of play the sound and cranked up this slider till it sounded about right. So there's no math behind it or anything, just did it till it sounded about right. The destination that it's modifying, of course, the rate. So LFO2 is affecting the rate, so the destination would be LFO1 rate. And then no aux source for that. I'm not switching between anything. Could choose macro too. So we could choose to switch between the rates. So that's of course always an option as well, and now it's in here, so can just kind of switch between LFO rates on the fly. So that's pretty much it for that patch. Hope you guys enjoyed, like the video, and with that being said, I hope you guys have a good one.